Hey, good morning. Good Friday morning to everyone. We're going to wait for just a couple of minutes to begin our 10 by 10. If you have already logged on, popped on, just let us know that you're here with us. We'd love to say hello to you, and we're glad that you're here with us this morning. So just pop on, push those thumbs up, those hearts. Let us know you're here through the comments. And as we're going throughout our teaching today, let us know you're here. Hey, Terry, good to see you. Hey, Patty, good to see you too. Praise God. The Hopper House is watching, and we just have expectation that blessing is on the Hopper House. Amen. Praise God. Good morning, Rose. Praise the Lord. We've got a good word happening today, guys. It's going to be good. Just believe a lot of people are going to be helped, and it's going to be good. Good morning, David. Good to see you. Just waiting for another minute, guys, for people to pop on. All right, we are going to get started with our 10 by 10 this morning. We're so glad that you've all joined in. And we are going to talk about taking courage today. We're in our main text out of John 14, 27, where Jesus is speaking to his disciples and he's speaking to you. And he says, "My peace I give to you, not as the world gives, give I unto you. Therefore, do not let your hearts be troubled and do not be afraid." And in the Passion Translation, it says, "But be courageous." And so we're going to talk today about being courageous in the Lord. And a scripture that we're going to begin in is found in Colossians chapter 1 and verse 27. And it says, "To them, God has chosen to make known among the Gentiles the glorious riches of this mystery, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory." So Colossians chapter 1 and verse 27, Christ in you, the hope of glory. And so I just want you to just think about you right now. The Bible says Christ is in you, and he gives you a hope and an expectation that he's going to show up in and through your life in a big way. 1 John 4:4 says it this way: "Greater is he that lives in you than he that lives in the world." And that's not just talking about just the person of Jesus, but it's everything that Jesus brings to your life, because he's in you and he's all sufficient in and through you above anything that you will ever face in this life. And so we're talking today about taking courage and having a hope and an expectation, because Jesus is in you if you are a believer in Jesus and you have professed him as your Lord and your Savior. We're going to look at David said it this way in Psalms 27 and in verse 13. He said, "I remain confident of this, I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living." In other words, in this life, not just when I go to heaven, but in this life, I'm going to see God's goodness. I'm going to see God's faithfulness. I'm going to see the bigness of God showing up in and through me. Peter said it this way in 2 Peter verse chapter 1 and verse 3. He said, "For as you know him better," as you get to know the Lord better, as you grow in your relationship with him, he will give you through His great power everything you need to live a good life. And in other versions, it says a godly life through His own glory and goodness. You have everything that you will ever need to succeed in your life and to get through any obstacle that comes into your path through Jesus that lives on the inside of you and through the resources that He provides through His presence in your life. And again, it says in Colossians that it's Christ in you, the hope of glory. The next thing, so the first thing is take courage, because the greatest resource lives on the inside of you. Take courage. Number two, take courage, have a hope and an expectation that God is not a withholder, but He is a giver. Have the hope and the expectation that God is not a withholder. He's not withholding from you, but He is freely giving to you. It says in Romans chapter 8 and in verse 32, He says, since God did not spare even His own Son, but gave Him up for us all, won't He also give us everything else? In Romans 8:32, God says, I've given you Jesus. If I've given you Jesus, why wouldn't I give you anything else that you're needing in your life? And so take courage, have a hope and an expectation that God is not going to withhold from you, but that He is going to give you everything that you are needing in this life. Number three, take courage. Can you guys just say that with me? Take courage. Say, I'm taking courage right now. Take courage. Have a hope and an expectation that God is answering prayer. Hallelujah. Have a hope and an expectation that God is answering your prayers. I just want you to say that with me. Say, God answers my prayers. Amen. What an encouragement. God answers my prayers. In 1 John 5 and verses 14 through 15, 1 John 5 verses 14 through 15, it reads, and this is the confidence. I have confidence. I have courage that I have in Him, that if I ask anything according to His will, He hears me. And if I know that He hears me, I know I have the petitions that I've asked of Him. And you might ask yourself, well, what is God's will? God's word is God's will. So when you ask according to His word, the Bible says you can be sure that heaven has heard you, and you can be sure that heaven is answering you, that your answer is on the way right now. And so a good thing to do while you're in the waiting is to just get up every morning and just say, Father, I thank you that you've heard my prayers. I thank you that you hear me, because you are my good Father. And Father, I thank you, Lord, that you've answered me, and that the answer is mine right now. It's en route to me right now. I'm in receipt of it right now, because I've asked according to your word. And so I just want you to take courage today that God is answering your prayers. The next thing that I want us to look at is to take courage. We have a hope and an expectation that we have no lack. So I want you to just think about that. Say, I have no lack. Amen. So I have a hope and an expectation that I have no lack. And so you might say, what is that in regards to? It's in regards to any area in your life where you're lacking something. If you're lacking health, the Bible says you have no lack, that He took your infirmities and He bore your sicknesses, and by the stripes of Jesus, you were healed. It's already a done deal. And so you can just stand up and you can boldly proclaim, I'm healed in Jesus' name, because he bore my sicknesses and he bore my infirmities. And so you can say, I'm whole, I'm strong, I'm strengthened in my body right now from the top of my head to the soles of my feet. You might say, I'm lacking in my relationships, or I'm lacking in the confidence that I'm accepted before God. And you can say, no, the word says I've been accepted in the beloved. The word says I'm the apple of his eye. The word says I'm a child of God when I ask Jesus into my life, that I'm a co-heir with Christ, that I'm seated with Christ in heavenly places, far above all principality, power, might, and dominion. I don't lack acceptance. I don't lack the love of God, because the love of God has been shed abroad in my heart by the Holy Spirit. And so you might say, I might be lacking in my pocketbook. Well, the word says that when we get involved in his kingdom finances, that he supplies for all of our needs according to his glorious riches in Christ Jesus. Luke 6:38 says, give and it shall be given unto you. A good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. And so I just want you to take courage today that you have a hope and an expectation that you have no lack. Now, what's crazy is we're just going to get to our text now. That was just a filler. But praise God, you have no lack because he's in you. The great resource is in you. The great giver is in you. The good father is in you. And so in Psalms 23:1, it says, the Lord is my shepherd. I have all that I need. Praise God. We have all that we need because he is our shepherd. And you know, he's watchfully taking care of you today. In Psalms 34 and verses 9 and 10, Psalms 34 verses 9 and 10, it reads, fear the Lord, or respect the Lord is another way that we can say that. You, his holy people, for those who fear or respect him and respect his ways lack nothing. The lions may grow weak and hungry, but those who seek the Lord lack no good thing. And so if something's good, the word says when you're a seeker of God, when you're not just seeking the resource, but you're seeking him, you're not just seeking the resources, I should say, but you're seeking the resource, you're seeking the Father God. The word says when you're a seeker of him, he rewards those who diligently seek him, it says in Hebrews. And so I just want you to be encouraged today. I want you to take courage today, because the great resource, Christ, is in you, and he's the hope of glory. You can have a hope and an expectation that he's going to show up in and through your life today. Amen. Amen. We just want to make you aware of just something that's going on tomorrow. Our Light the Bay Church is hooking up with Love a Child Ministries, which is located in Pittsburgh, California. And we are collecting toiletries, toilet paper, paper towels, hygiene products like disinfectant soaps and shampoos and conditioners, and then also cleaning supplies so that they can keep their environment sterile and clean. You can drop off all of those supplies between the hours of 9 a.m. and 10 a.m. at Light the Bay Church, and this will be at 1210 Stoneman Avenue. 1210 Stoneman Avenue. You can drop off those products from 9 to 10 a.m. and we will make sure that those resources get into these women and these children's lives, and we can bring the light and the love of Jesus to these families. We want to thank you so much for tuning in with us today. We look forward to seeing you tomorrow again at 10 a.m. Have a wonderful day.